Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's David, and today I'm going to be reviewing one of the smallest and lightest 100 amp hour lithium iron phosphate batteries on the market today. This is the LiTime 100 amp hour mini lithium iron phosphate 12 volt battery, and it is tiny compared to all the other 100 amp hour batteries I have. And I'm going to show you exactly what I'm talking about here so you can see for yourself. So this is the 100 amp hour lithium iron phosphate battery by Renogy. This is also the heated model. They did a really good job at making this as compact as possible, but LiTime still takes the cake. It is still smaller, not by much. It is a little bit thinner, about an inch shorter in length there. I'll line it up so you can see about an inch. And then LiTime is actually probably about an inch and a half taller. But with that said, when it comes to weight as well, they're pretty close, but LiTime still lighter. This is the 100 amp hour power queen, and this is where LiTime really shines. So when you look at the length, there is easily probably about 2 inches there in length, height, very similar. LiTime is actually a smidge taller. And then obviously when it comes to width, LiTime is going to be definitely slimmer. This is the Time USB battery. Again, way bigger than LiTime. Easily 2 or more inches in length. Height, again, LiTime is just like a smidge taller, maybe a quarter inch for the width. It's just easily almost 2 inches slimmer. Now, let me show you, this is impressive. So this is the Renogy 200 amp hour lithium iron phosphate Bluetooth battery. I have a review on this, so be sure to check it out if you're interested in a Bluetooth battery, but this is actually insane because this being 200 amp hours, the length of this is almost the same width of this. So it is maybe half an inch longer than this is wider. But if you were to buy these instead of Renogy's 200 amp hour battery, you could fit 1, 2, 3, 4. So you could have 400 amp hours of power with the LiTime, or you could have 200 amp hours with the Renogy. Granted, this has Bluetooth, but that's easily fixable because all you have to do is buy a Victron battery monitor with Bluetooth for this guy and you're laugh. So this battery is 35% smaller and 25% lighter, weighing in at just 19 pounds. This battery also has a price tag of just $350. It has a 5-year warranty. It has 6,000 cycles at 80% DOD or 4,000 cycles at 100% DOD, which is pretty impressive. This has a 100 amp hour BMS with a 250 amp 5-second surge if you require it. So you can charge this battery with 100 amps or you can discharge it with 100 amps. The BMS has all your normal protection features except for one. It has overvoltage, undervoltage, overheating, overcurrent, and short circuit. But it is missing low temperature cutoff, which is a huge deal for me living up here in Canada. Me and Kaylee travel in the winter, and I need that low temperature cutoff to make sure I don't damage those cells. If you live in a colder climate, I wouldn't recommend this battery, but if you live in a more mild, temperate, warmer climate, and you're in need of something really small, this is gonna be the perfect battery for you. The trick to making this battery so small was the fact that LiTime actually used pouch cells, which are the same or similar cells that Renogy uses. You can connect the LiTime battery in up to 4P4S, which is going to be up to 16 batteries for a 48 volt system. This makes just over 20 kilowatt hours of power. Of course, if you want to just have parallel or series, you can connect it in smaller battery banks, making 12, 24, or 48 volt systems. I've gone ahead and installed the LiTime 100 amp hour battery in my solar system. I haven't turned anything on yet. All I did was hook up negative and the positive. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my main battery switch there. And then I'm going to turn on my solar. We are at 13.2 volts and there's not a ton of sun out today, so we're only getting 6 0.3 amps, but I'm gonna go ahead and hook up to shore power and try to charge this guy at 65 amps. That's the max that I can charge through my inverter. And we'll see how battery takes it. It'll pick up automatically that I'm in shore power. And you can see that voltage going way up. Looks like it leveled out at about 63 amps. The battery's been taking charge for about 15 minutes. No issues at all. It's been going between kind of 60 and 65 amps, depending on how much solar we're getting. Yeah, the battery's not getting hot at all. This is about 60 to 65% of what the battery can take, but charging it at 100 amp hours is not healthy for the battery. So charging a lithium battery is always better to do slowly if you can. All right, on to the discharge test. I've unplugged it from shore power, and now I'm gonna go ahead and switch on my water heater. This is gonna pull over 100 amps, which is more than this battery can take, but we're gonna see how it discharges and if the BMS kicks in or not. So we're pulling about 122 amps right now for that water heater, and let's see how long this battery can manage to do that for. So the water heater was on for about 15 minutes. Granted, it's not that hot out right now, but the battery performed awesome. It didn't cut out, and I was actually pulling more than it is limited for. So as far as the overcurrent on the BMS, I'm not sure if that's gonna be all that accurate for 100, and I was pulling about 126 amp. I'm sure if it were to overheat, it would definitely cut off. I'm gonna leave this installed in my solar system and test it out for a while. I'll let you guys know in the comments below if I have any issues or any other information that I wanna share with you guys while I'm using this, but I'm really excited to test it out for the next little while. If you guys have any questions regarding LiTime's mini 100 amp hour battery, feel free to comment below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. If you found this video useful, like the video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell to be notified, because I'm going to be coming out with a lot more battery reviews soon. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.